children, today we are going to learn 5th chapter multiplication. So before starting the chapter, we must know what is multiplication. Already you have learned in previous classes, multiplication means repeated addition. Instead of adding the same number again and again, we say the multiplication tables and we do the calculation in short. Okay, now we are going to learn about multiplication, so we must know the properties of multiplication. So today the main thing you are going to learn, 5 properties of multiplication. The first one is multiplicative property of zero. The second one, multiplicative property of one. Third one, order property of multiplication. Fourth one, grouping property of multiplication. And fifth one, distributive property of multiplication over addition. Okay. So now we are going to learn about all these 5 properties. Why should we learn these properties? Isn't it? Always you may think, why we have to learn about these properties? So when we learn these properties, it will be useful when we do the calculation of large numbers. When we do the calculation of large numbers, this will be really useful. Okay? Now here, the first one, multiplicative property of zero. Multiplicative property of zero. That means any number, if you multiply by 0, you get the answer 0. Any number, if you multiply by 0, you get the answer 0. For example, 2 multiply by 0. What is the answer? You may know, you have learned in 1st, 2nd, 3rd standard. So, 2 zeros are 0. Whenever you multiply any number by 0, you get the product 0. So, this is the multiplicative property of 0. The second one is multiplicative property of 1. Multiplicative property of 1. Multiplicative property of 1. So, whenever we multiply any number by 1, you get the product the same number. Isn't it? 2 ones are 2. 3 ones are 3. 4 ones are 4. 5 ones are 5. Isn't it? Whenever you multiply by 1, the multiplicand will be the product. Both will be the same number. Both will be the same number. Whenever you multiply by 1, you get the same number as answer. Okay, this is the multiplicative property of 1. Now, the third one is order property. Order property of multiplication. This is whenever you multiply, minimum you may have 2 numbers. You may have 2 or more numbers. Minimum you may have 2 numbers. For example, let me take 2 multiply by 3. What 2 threes are? 6. The same time when you have 3 multiply by 2. 3 twos are 6. So when you change the place of the number, when you change the order of the number, there will be no difference in the answer. There will be no difference in the product. When you change the order of the number, ye order ko idhar se idhar change karne se, uska answer mein koi farak nahi padne wala. This is called order property. Okay? Now third one is, fourth one is grouping property. Grouping property of multiplication. So when you have three or more numbers to multiply, so you cannot say the table at random for all the numbers. For example, now I am telling 2, 3, 4. So I cannot multiply at a time all three numbers. एक ही बार में ऐसे सबकी table बोल दें, ये तो नहीं हो सकता. So I have to select any two numbers. जैसे अभी मैं ये दोनों को लिया, 2, 3 are 6 बोला, फिर उसके बाद then I take the next number, 6, 4 are 24, isn't it? The same thing if I take other two number, any number you can take. If I take 3, 4, 3 4s are 12, 3 4s are 12, then 12 2s are 2, 12s are 24. The answer is same. You take any number as a group, any numbers as a group, then you multiply, then you take the third number and multiply, you get the same answer. Okay, this is called grouping property. क्योंकि एक ही बार में सबकी टेबल बोलना बोल नहीं सकते हैं, तो इसलिए पहले इन दोनों को लिया, टेबल बोला, फिर तीसरा नंबर लिया. यहां पर वो और कोई दो नंबर को लिया, मल्टीप्लाई किया, फिर इसको लेके मल्टीप्लाई किया, तब भी आंसर सेम आया. दिस इज कॉल्ड ग्रुपिंग प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मल्टीप्लीकेशन ओवर एडिशन. इन दिस एडिशन ऑल्सो इज कमिंग डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव प्रॉपर्टी. Distributive property. For example, I am giving you 2 multiplied by 5 plus 3. Okay, one multiplication also is there, addition also is there. The next one, the same thing, 2 multiplied by 5 plus 3. In two ways I can do. One thing, I can add the number and I can multiply these two by that sum. ठीक है, just first you add the number 5 plus 3 8, then 2 8s are 16. ये भी कर सकती हूँ. Otherwise I can do in this way, 2 5s are 2 5s. I can distribute the number. Two fives are, then 2 3s are. This addition I have distributed in two places, then 2 5s are 10 plus 2 3s are 6, then I am adding the number, then 16. But anyhow the answer is same, whether you do take the sum then you multiply, otherwise you just distribute these numbers then multiply then you add the sum, then you get the sum, you get the same answer. This is called distributive property of multiplication over addition. These are 5 properties of multiplication. This can be used in doing the calculation in large numbers. That will be easy for us to do. Okay. So now in your book we have exercise 13. In the next video, I will explain you how you are going to apply these properties, this logic in the exercise. Okay? Thank you.